So what is a VPS? A VPS stands for a virtual private server, also known as a virtual dedicated or dedicated virtual. There's different names for it, but basically the most common one is a VPS or virtual private server. What that is it's web hosting, and it's in between shared web hosting and dedicated web hosting or a dedicated server. With shared web hosting, it's pretty much you're in this pool with tons of other people. And typically, if you're with providers like the HostGators, Bluehost, and GoDaddy's, they're really slow. And then you have the dedicated servers where you get the full machine. But what about in between? That's where the VPS is coming in, and which, in my opinion, is probably one of the best solutions. Especially if you're running, for example, like an e-commerce software like Magento or OS Commerce, or any kind of even WordPress, you know, if you have anything more than just a brochure website, because the speed of the load time affects SEO, and also of course it affects your user experience as well. With a VPS, what it means is you have a full server, and they call this the VPS node. A VPS node is basically the actual server that these VPSs are hosted on. What VPS is, it's you take a server, you slice up into a few big chunks, and each of those chunks is kind of like its own micro environment, its own operating system. You can have so it's basically from the software's perspective, it's basically having a full server just without the full resources. And the cool thing with that is, unlike the shared hosting, where if one customer on that web hosting, on that web host is using up tons of resources, everyone's sites are going to run slow. With the VPS, because it's similar to the dedicated server, everything is partitioned. If the next guy that has a VPS is just, you know, destroying their resources because they're running a really heavy video website where it requires tons of software to compress the video, stuff like that, it wouldn't affect your server, which is a really cool thing about the VPSs. Another cool thing about the VPSs is also with the shared hosting, if you need to upgrade space, yeah, you can. But these days, everyone's offering this bogus unlimited or close to unlimited, where you have just tons of resources. And my thing with that is, if every hosting company's clients used even half of that, they'd all go out of business. Those are just fancy numbers that they throw out. But if you actually start using the resources, then shared hosting obviously wouldn't work. With the dedicated servers, if you need to upgrade, you would have to have your data center or hosting provider physically add memory to there, or add an additional hard drive, or move you to a more powerful server. With the VPSs, if you need to scale, it's relatively easy. Basically, all of these VPS hosting companies have the ability to raise your the space, raise the memory, and add on another virtual CPU if you need, which is great for scalability, because when you don't need it, you don't have to pay for it, and when you need it, it's simple. And the other cool thing is, with the shared hosting, if your website's running slow, you basically need to contact the web host, and they need to either restart the server for everybody, or they kind of tell you, this is kind of how it is. With the dedicated servers, if something's running slowly, you actually have to call into your web host or data center, and they will have to physically restart the machine. Or some of them actually have these things called remote. Basically, they can restart the machine remotely, but usually you will have to contact your web host for them to do that. With the VPS, most VPS providers, including out my web hosting company, and we have a full team, you will actually have a login. You can log in and you can restart your virtual private server. You can shut it down and then start it back up. So you have this. It's a very powerful ability to have full control over your VPS, whether you are on or off. And the other cool thing is, just like the dedicated server, you can decide to have Linux or Windows or any flavor of Linux, depending on what you or your development team prefers. So that's also one of the very cool things about the VPS is it's basically your own environment. So hopefully that gives a pretty good understanding of what the VPS is. And again, like I said, for most e-commerce websites, I recommend the VPS if you're doing much more than, you know, you can upgrade to a dedicated server. But yeah, for most e-commerce websites, a VPS or most websites that's a little more than a brochure website, I recommend the VPS options. And yeah, if you're looking for a reliable company, I obviously recommend my company, and we have two hosting brands, and we have really, really affordable prices, starting at $15 and ranging to high performance VPS hosting that's $100 and up. So we provide the full range. So go to my blog yanhuang.me, and then you can click on our hosting brands and check out what features that we have. And of course, if you have any questions whatsoever, you can feel free to go to my blog yanhuang.me, click on contact, shoot me an email directly, and I'll be more than happy to get back to you and answer any questions. And if you found this video helpful, please like the video, and once you're on my blog, like the Facebook, and 1+ the Google+.